Now, here's my last point. Maybe the most important thing, and I think I'm the only one who talks about this, but every president that I know of, at least since Harry Truman, has commented on the difference between a speech and a solution, a promise, and real progress. How hard it is to do what you say you're going to do. Harry Truman was a great president, and he said, you know, sometimes even when I sign an executive order, I'm never sure anything's going to happen. I once made a crack when I was president. I was having trouble getting something done. I said, some days I wake up and go to work and I feel like the superintendent of the cemetery. I know there's a lot of people under me, but I'm not sure anybody's listening. I mean, this is a serious point. She's the best change maker I've ever known. My daughter got us in trouble in Indiana, and they asked her if they thought her mother would be a better president than her dad. She said, sure, I do. So I called her, and I thought Chelsea would say, oh, Dad, chill out. You can't run for anything. You're yesterday's news. She's on the ballot. What do you expect me to say? That's not what she said. She said, Dad, they asked me a direct question. I had to give an honest answer. And I have to tell you, for this time, I agree with my daughter. Because she understands this home mortgage crisis, which is important, and has the only plan to stop it in its tracks, because of her national security experience. She gets this, and she is a change maker. She got 70% of the vote in the Arkansas Democratic primary. She's running 15 points ahead of John McCain down there in a state that's only voted Democrat 3 times in 44 years, because they know her, and they know she can change people's lives. We got people from Arkansas that went all over this country. Some of them went all the way to New Hampshire when they couldn't afford the trip with a little brochure they wrote themselves. They said, read these things she did to change our lives. 40 of New York's 62 counties are Republican counties that voted to re-elect President Bush. 2 years later, she got 60% of the vote in those counties. Farmers from those counties gone all over America saying, you really ought to think about voting for this woman because she is the only person who ever actually did anything that changed our lives. It helped us raise our families and produce our crops and sell them and reduce our energy use and actually do things to change our lives. There has been a direct correlation in how Hillary has done in these primaries and the percentage of voters that need a president. I mean a president to change the course of America. And if you look at the surveys, the last 3 national polls, she runs better than Senator McCain, even after the press did their usual pounding on her after North Carolina and Indiana. She's still running better. And let me remind you of what the facts were before they were rewritten. First, her opponent said, well, she'll win in Pennsylvania, I'll win in North Carolina, and Indiana will be the tiebreaker. Pretty good bet for him since it's right next to Illinois, and 30% of the voters are in the Chicago media market, and he outspent her 4-1. She won anyway, so the news story is, North Carolina was a tiebreaker, this election's over. Let me tell you something. One of Clinton's laws of politics, I got a long way with my little laws of politics. Some of them are kind of funny. Like, if someone tells you it's nothing personal, take a deep breath. They're about to stick it to you. But here's one of my rules. If someone tells you you can't win, it's because they know you can and they're afraid you will. Now, it just depends on what you want. But you hide and watch what West Virginia wants Tuesday. Because they have a very high percentage of people who need a president. And Montana last night, I met by a woman, asked me to sign pictures of her 88-year-old mother who is on the verge of death. Her mother is in a bed circling Hillary's name in the absentee ballot. She said, before I go, I've got to give this woman a chance to be president. Day before, I'm in a little town in West Virginia. 11-year-old boy comes up to me and says, here, I open up, there's a check for $422. I said, how did you get this money? He said, well, first I sold everything I didn't need. 11-year-old boy. I sold my bicycle for $30. I sold every video game I had for $6. And then I still didn't have enough, so I went up and down the street telling people what I'd done and asking them to give me $1 or $5 or $10. And I got up to this, give it to her. I want her to win. Now, let me tell you something, folks. That's why she's still in this race. I outspent $4 million in Texas. one anyway. Outspent 2-1 in Ohio, one anyway. Outspent by $8 million, 3-1 in Pennsylvania. Won 61 of 67 counties just like this one, because people like you in places like this decided she'd be the best president. It's really up to you. But I'm just telling you, this is not about her or her opponent. It's about you. It's about who will give you the best future. She's the best I ever saw. I'd be here for her if we had never been married. Yeah, I love her. But, you know, we'd have more fun if you'd send her back home and we could take a few trips in our declining years. I think it's best for you, because I think she's the best candidate I've ever supported. And I hope you will agree. Thank you. God bless you.